Yeah, Ken and I would like to do something together for you guys, if you wouldn't mind. This is a pretty special song. Ken, do you want to give him a background on it? It's called Annie Laurie. You're probably familiar.
A little bit Scottish folk song. It's one of those songs that has endured through the years and has an interesting story, which I'm not going to belabor at any great length, but Annie Laurie was a real person. And she lived, it's in the 1600s in the lowlands area of Scotland. She was a bit of a coquette, evidently, and was pursued by a man named Douglas, who was somewhat older than she was. And her father didn't approve of the joining. But Douglas wrote the poem about Annie Laurie, Maxwell and Braise or Bonnie, and gave it to Annie. And the poem survived about 200 years later in the early 1800s, a Scottish lady in the same area of Scotland found it and put it to music, the song that we all know as Annie Laurie. And it was 100 years after that Charles Badger Clark, the poet Larry App of South Dakota, wrote a poem that he called The Bad Half Hour, in which he built on Annie Laurie. So, never having done this before, my Trinity and I are going to try and do it for you. So, it's A Bad Half Hour, and it's Annie Laurie. You're on.
Maxwell's Braise or Bonnie, where early falls the dew, and 'twas there that Annie Laurie gave me her promise true, gave me. Which ne'er forget will be, ever Bonnie and me Laurie. I'd lay me doon and ee, her brow is like the snowdrift, her neck is like the swan. Her face, it is the fairest that e'er the sun shone on. That e'er the sun shone on. Dark blue is her eye, and for Bonnie and Glory, I'd lay me down and eat.
Moon, don't know why I feel so restless. Moon is shining clear and bright. Cattle all are resting easy, but I just can't sleep tonight. There ain't no cactus in my blankets. Don't know why they seem so hard. Listen, it's Orban Jim singing Annie Laurie out on guard. Annie Laurie, wish you'd quit it. Couldn't sleep now if I tried. Makes the night seem big and lonesome, and my throat feels sore inside. How my Annie used to sing it. It sounded good and gay. Nights I drove her home from dances when the east was turning gray. Yes, her brow was like a snowdrift, and her eyes like gentle stream, and her face, I still can see it, all too frequent in my dreams. And her hand was all a-trembly that night beneath the tree, when I couldn't help but tell her she meant all the world to me. But her folks said I was wild, restless, unsettled, they was right, for I leaned to herding cattle, and I'm at it still tonight. She married young Doc Wilkins. Oh my Lord, but that was hard. Wish that fool had quit his singing Annie Laurie out on guard. Good times are all past me, don't ever seem to come again. I just don't like it thinking of all the things that happened then. What's that? My turn? Heat me up some coffee, Clark. At least I'll stop old Jim from singing Annie Laurie out on guard.
Like dew at summer lying, 'tis far fairy feet, and like wind in summer sighing, her voice is low and sweet. Her voice is low and sweet. She's all the world to me, and for Bonnie and me, Laurie, I'd lay me to.
Great job, Ken.
Good job.
Thank you guys so much.